correct?
Exactly. It has to be pure Aryan blood, which is understood to be divine Luciferian blood.
And, okay, so what you've explained there is what they believe. What do you believe, then, about this?
Oh, gosh, where do you want me to start? I mean, it's the Antichrist.
Do you think that there is some element of truth in this, or is that total bunk? You know, do they make this up in order to prop themselves up to create a story here, or what do you think?
Well, you know, my personal conviction is I'm a Muslim, so I believe it's likely true. There's a verse in the Quran that implies that the devil was permitted to interbreed with human beings, and this is a notion that's been around for years, that disembodied spirits can produce offspring with human beings. In the Middle Ages, they were called succubi or incubi.
Right.
And you know, if Rosemary's Baby is very much that idea as well, right? Hmm. They hold a ritual, and the devil comes and impregnates a woman to produce the Antichrist.
Right.
But in a cult ritual, this is called a sacred marriage. In fact, this is a very important, this is the central point of the Da Vinci Code. And he says what he calls a hero's gamos, because it's he accurately calls it that because it's an ancient occult ritual of sacred marriage. And the story is important because the woman Sophie, which is another important occult
name.
Yes. She stumbles on her grandfather in the midst of an occult sexual rite of sacred marriage, which we are to understand by from Dan Brown is that's supposed to be the true Christianity, which is utter nonsense. But that sacred ritual is to produce, just to continue the bloodline, right? And it's the priest and priestess impersonate the god and goddess. What's supposed to happen is that the priest is supposed to, in that ritual, is supposedly possessed by the god. So the child is actually the child of Lucifer. And this is how they continue the bloodline, so that these kings and queens are just living embodiments of the purest incarnations of this bloodline.
Hmm. So I mean, we can work ourselves up here a little bit, so to speak, into the, you know, more modern era. What is going on now? And I want to ask you a little bit about the Rothschilds and what is known as the Grail bloodline. We have about 5 minutes left in this segment before we can take a break and continue. But we can begin maybe to talk a little bit about the Rothschilds and what I guess you would refer to as the Grail bloodline. Does that carry on from that tradition that you just talked about in regards to the Dan Brown kind of mythology that they're building up right now? What do you think?
Absolutely. It's the Holy Grail is the mythology of this bloodline. And it helps to explain the whole basis of it. And what I discovered is that while they claim to come from, you know, they claim to come from Nimrod, from the fallen angels, Egyptian kings, and so on and so forth, what I did find is that the bloodlines focus back, they can all be traced back to Herod the Great. And that's the real key.
Hmm. Okay. Hmm.
Do you know who Herod the Great was?
Yeah, give us a little bit of background on him, if you will, for our listeners.
Well, basically, he was part of a family who were Edomites, and the Edomites were actually descended not from they weren't really Jewish. They were descendants of Esau, who were so it was the Jews were descended from Isaac. Whereas the Edomites were descended from Isaac's brother, Esau, who took the name Edom because he was red.
Hmm.
And so King Herod was a member of a family of Edomites who had converted to Judaism. So there was a bit of resentment against their rule because they weren't considered real Jews. But King Herod was the one when the Magi came to him and told him that they had witnessed the birth of the Messiah, he orders the slaughter of the innocents, which is basically a euphemism for child sacrifice again, on, except this time on a mass scale. And he orders the slaughter of all the firstborn sons, but Mary and Joseph escape to Egypt. And Jesus eventually survives. And that's a very important point. So he's the evil king of the Bible who tries to eliminate Jesus.
Right. So the Rothschilds, do you think, basically ties back to King Herod then? Is that what you're saying here?
Well, just considered Red Shield.
Yes.
I'm being vague right now because we only have a few minutes left, but there's a lot to talk about.
I understand. Yes. Yeah. Well, why don't we take a break at this point? Then we can continue talking more in our member section. But I do want to give out some of your details. Of course, I want you to mention both of your websites again, and I also want to give you an opportunity to mention where people can go if they want to pick up copies of your either one or both of your books. Where would they go to do that?
My first book, the Dying God, the Hidden History of Western Civilization, is at thedyinggod.com. And my more recent book, Terrorism and the Illuminati, is at www.terrorism-illuminati.com. There's also a PDF version of my book available for free on the site. And the entire book can be read on the site as well.
Very good. So there's a lot of information up there, and do check it out in case you want to a physical version of that, of course. And you have links to where people can get the book?
Yes, I do. Yeah, you can buy it at Amazon as well. Yeah.
Very good. Okay, well, thank you very much for this segment here, David. Stay with us. We'll take a short break and we'll continue in a little while.
Thank you very much.